Hope that train brings us some rain, Brother Stevens.
Hot as spring in years. Feels like July already.
And if we don't get some water before long, we might as well be planting rocks.
You know the trouble with you, Brother Higgins?
I have the feeling I'm about to be enlightened.
You don't have enough faith.
You know the trouble with you, Brother White? You stop working when you talk. And it seems like you're always talking.
Now, I didn't mean to get you all stirred up. It just seems like you're a pessimist.
Oh, if I was a pessimist, I'd be sitting back at home in the shade saying, it ain't gonna rain again this year. And if it is, the crickets are gonna come and eat up half our crops anyhow. It's the optimist who grabs their shovel when there's work to be done.
Well, now, maybe there's a difference between faith and grit. I'm not saying you don't have plenty of grit.
I plant my seed every spring like the rest of you. All I'm saying is, the fuller the barn, the easier the faith. And the rougher the hands, the fuller the barn. But for some reason, God seems to bless those with calloused hands as much as them with calloused knees.
Well, now, we all go into the welcome social tonight? Well, how about you, Brother Stevens?
Of course I am. We crossed the plains in the same company 22 years ago now.
You bringing all three wives?
Well, who'd be happy left at home besides me?
Okay. How about you, Brother Higgins? You going?
I'm going to head up and check the new reservoir first. Not that there'll be much in it. Way ahead of schedule. Wasn't supposed to get here till noon.
Well, can you see it?
There it is. See the smoke?
You reckon Tully and Martha are on it?
Well, they sent a wire. They're on it, all right.
Now, why do you think they wanted to come back to the Deseret territory anyhow, after 20 years?
Oh, likely the same reason that you decided to stay here instead of chase that gold with them.
And just why is that?
You're stupid.
They've gone and joined the two halves of the country. The eastern half is now hooked to the west. And where do you suppose they chose to do it?
Right here where the living's best. I heard they took a photograph to prove it. I left somebody wrote a fancy verse.
Those two big locomotives nose to nose there.
They had to put them in reverse.
Golden spine, high golden spine.
Promontory point for living things.
Golden spine, high golden spine.
This land of ours will never be the same.
Now we can buy the things we left behind us.
And we can have some things we've gone without.
We'll listen for the train to blow its whistle.
When it comes, we'll give a shout. Think of the tools and pots and pans we'll get now. The living cloth our cheeks can touch again. Piano fortes were too big to carry. In the covered wagons cross the plains.
We're free to come
and go
now.
Someday I'm gonna climb aboard the train. we're moving on again.
I wonder about our homes back in Missouri. What do you think is happening in Nauvoo?
Now we can leave the train up at the station
and go wherever we want to.
Did you hear it?
It'll be a few more minutes.
You should be right up front when it arrives. Oh, where's Allyson?
Well, she's up at the stream with a wash.
She wouldn't want to miss this. Oh, please, Papa, hurry.
Free to go. Someday I'm gonna climb up on that train.
The land is there.
For us to know. And maybe I'll go back across the plains.
The golden spot,
promontory point for living fame.
This land of ours will never be the same.
Oh, Papa, you're the mayor.
I guess that cornfield will have to wait a bit today.
I guess so.
Things are changing fast here now, Brother Stevens. This territory of ours, with people coming in or just passing through with different ideas, new ways of living. Our children, you know, with 8 children, you're lucky you had Jacob first. If all your other children grow up to be like him.
And you had another daughter like Allyson.
Well, I do.
Mary Beth's only 17.
Yeah, I know. But for some reason, she seems to think her older sister's plucking the only apple off the tree. And whenever I remind her how young she is, she reminds me that her mother was the same age when she married me. Tully! And Martha!
Hello.
Well, our first arrivals on the Transcontinental Railroad.
I forgot how hot it is here.
Well, this year more than usual.
And who are all these handsome people? When we left, there were only 11 families.
Now, you've changed, I've changed, the whole town has changed, for the good, mostly. With that little sawmill you and I built, oh, you should see it now. Tully and Martha, tell us what you've been up to these last 20 years.
In 47, we crossed the plains in wagons and settled here just like the prophet said. But in 9, when they found gold in California, we left to seek our fortunes there instead. I never panned a single golden nugget. I never staked a claim or worked a stream. But when all them miners came in rich and hungry, I traded them their gold for bread and beans.
Welcome back to the mountains. Welcome back to the place we call our home. Welcome back from wherever you ever left our deseret to roam. Welcome back to the valley. Welcome back to the place where you belong.
The glitter disappeared within a decade. There really was no reason that we stayed. So we gathered up our goods and our possessions and headed off to San Francisco Bay.
Well, we bought a mercantile next to a tavern and loaded up the shelves with all delights. We sold silks and pots and candies in the daytime and boarded up the windows every night.
Welcome back to the mountains. Welcome back to the best folk in the land. Welcome back to the laborers, where your neighbors always lend a helping hand. Welcome back to the valley. Welcome back to the sand and to the sun.
Fashion. How we prospered there, but one.
said we're moving, back to the place we held so dear. And we vowed when we got back to this valley, we'd never move away again from here.
Sure it was him, and he's so handsome!
Oh, he just got off the train with his parents. Then they started unloading really fancy suitcases into trunks. I mean, he wasn't exactly helping unload. He was directing where things went from the platform.
What are you talking about?
Too stately for common labor like that. Not like the boys here. He's refined, I can tell, and I'm going to meet him tonight at the social.
Mary,
I can feel
Beth.
It. I've got to go get cleaned up already. Oh, this is so exciting! The first new boy to come into the valley in a year!
A boy.
Well, a man, really. Only I'm still just a girl, so... but not really. I don't want to be called a girl any longer. I think I'm probably more of a woman now, don't you think? I hope that's what he thinks. It doesn't really matter what you think. I mean, it does matter what you think, but not whether you think I'm a woman yet. I guess your chest does the speaking for you on that matter. Maybe if I just hold my shoulders back, then I... Well, anyways, I'm just going back home. You probably don't care about this sort of thing anymore.
Well, of course I care. Why wouldn't I?
Because you're already hitched. Almost. To the finest man ever. Oh, just think. After the harvest, you'll be Mrs. Jacob Stevens. Oh, hello, Jacob. I'll see you back home.
Why, Jacob Stevens.
Good morning.
I've never known you to break from work if there was still a ray of sunlight left in the sky. Let alone before noon.
Well, I heard the train whistle, so I thought you might need help carrying your wash back. You finished with it?
Until I do the same batch next week and the week after that. Do you remember how we used to come up here when we were children, Jacob? You and I? We'd swing from these twisted aspen trees and dream we were riding camels far away.
And wade across the ocean here.
Some days I'd like to just follow one of those little twigs along the stream, watching it bob up and down and seeing where it ends up.
Well, in the lake.
Well, maybe not. Maybe it'll get stuck behind a rock for a day or two and then get washed away by a heavy rain and continue on its journey downstream. Or maybe snag onto a beaver's tail and end up in one of those beaver dams upstream. I mean, that's the adventure of it. Not being certain. Isn't it kind of exciting in its own little way?
It's a twig.
So, if we're meeting at the social tonight, does that mean I at least get a float around the dance floor with you?
Do we let folks know tonight?
They're already talking.
For two summers now. Seems like all we ever end up doing is talking.
Well, can't we just wait a little?
No! Tonight, at the end of the social. Or else, I throw myself into the lake and drown.
You can't drown in that salty lake. Unless you float face down. Oh! All right. We'll see.
Tonight, I'm getting engaged to the most beautiful gal in the territory.
Here, carry this.
Oh, I'm sorry, I...
It's nothing. Go ahead, I'll wash it again. Jacob, will you be walking me home tonight?
Nothing could stop me. Woohoo!
Mama, tell me, sometimes I feel you standing very near. How can I make the right choice without knowing just what the choices really are? At night I stand outside and gaze up at the sky. How do I pick from heaven just one star? It's a virtue I know to feel contented, to give thanks each day for what I've got. It's the only life I have, I'm just wanting to be sure. And mama, oh mama, I'm not.
Now, just what makes you so sure?
The prophet, I'm telling you. The prophet.
Well, here we are. Come on inside. Well, you're looking as strong as ever, Tully.
You too. You must carry those logs to Sunday on your shoulder.
Well, this handsome son of yours, well, he came only to our knees when you left.
Daniel is the filthy champion of all the San Franciscos. Well.
Yes. My best kept heading west when you did, I'm afraid, Tully.
Well, go ahead, Jacob. Show them what these mountains build in us.
Oh, there we go, Jacob.
Go, Jacob. Come on, son.
This ought to be good.
You can do it, son.
All right.
Oh, my okay, Jacob.
Okay, Jacob.
Here we go.
Here we are.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh.
In these parts, it's best 2 out of 3.
Oh, okay. Should have mentioned that beforehand.
You go,
Jacob.
Come on, Jacob.
How about a tiebreak?
Let's see it.
I'll settle for a draw tonight, if that's all right with Daniel.
Yeah, another time then. Well, this food won't eat itself. Eat, dance, talk. These canyons give us everything we need. Well, you're going to love it back here, Martha. Oh, and you too, Daniel.
The desert. Hundreds of miles of desert. What can you love about it?
You're only looking one way, west. Well, if you look at these mountains around us, well, they stretch 50 miles or more.
And most of the years, there's green to them. Now, they'll pick your spirits right up if you let them.
We even trap beaver.
They're just walls, keeping you trapped in these valleys.
Or maybe keeping others out.
They catch our water for us, I'll tell you that.
And give us wood for our home.
And a place to go when it's hot. Oh, it's mighty pretty up there.
And you know what? They aren't going anywhere. So we,
so
can,
we
all...
can always count on them.
You know better than anyone, Jacob. You've hiked most of them and hauled down plenty of timber.
These old mountains here behind us have never let me down. Sometimes they seem that they have been the only friends around. They let you walk all over them and never make a frown. These old mountains behind us standing tall. When the clouds of rain pass over and we don't get a drop, and we're down in the valleys wanting water for our crops, these mountains here behind us reach right up and make it stop. These old mountains behind us standing tall. Just like God, these mountains will always be here, standing like sentinels around us. Just like God, these mountains, they beckon us to climb out of the desert that surrounds us.
If you climb up on those mountains, you'll see for miles around.
And every 10 or 20 miles, you'll see another town.
And when they start a rumbling, they'll make a frightful sound.
These old mountains behind us standing tall.
You can see them from the valley, from everywhere you go. When August comes, the highest ones still have their caps of snow.
When lightning strikes the rocky peaks, they put on quite a show.
These old mountains behind us standing tall.
Just like God, these mountains will always be here, standing like sentinels around us. Just like God, these mountains, they beckon us to climb out of the desert that surrounds us. And someday when these great mountains see the valleys filled below with gardens round the homes that make it blossom like a rose, they'll see the headstones marking where we lie in sweet repose.
These old mountains behind us standing tall. These old mountains behind us, just like all these mountains.
Protect us,
remind us, inspire us, provide for us, watch over us.
Care of one or two of those things right quick, don't you think?
Nah.
Such a welcome you've given us today. When we left, it was just a humble little village and such a hard life. And now, it's still such a humble little village.
But how it has grown.
Well, you've grown a bit yourself, Tully. Yeah, you've prospered while away here. We've had more posterity than prosperity.
And I hear there's paths all along the front of those mountains. How did they get started?
Well, the prophet, of course.
What's that you said? What did I hear? Something to my heart and soul so dear. That word I nearly worship. Did you say prophet?
Oh, yes, I did.
Well, bless my ears. If there's a prophet here in Zion, then I'm inclined to stay to make a little money and stash a bit away. You say you're guided by a prophet. Now that's a prudent course. For business without profits like a plow without a horse. This place of desolation, an oasis in the sand. The heat is far more bearable with silver in your hand. The infernal isolation here, it's more than I can stand. But a gold mine in them mountains makes remoteness rather grand. A prophet, they've seen a prophet. Well, now they're talking terms I understand. A prophet, they've seen a prophet? After all, that is what motivates a man. They've just followed the prophet to this valley they confide. What do they know that I don't? What secrets do you hide? Ah, the lovely scent of lucre is indeed a pleasant smell. They're onto something here now, I can sense it, I can tell. It's incredible the chattering about a prophet dear. It's incessant, effervescent, and it's music to my ear. They never mention losses, so there must be wealth galore. But they cleverly conceal their loot by acting pauper poor. Oh, a prophet, my word, a prophet. These people aren't as simple as they seem. I guess they're not so different than any other folk. In the end, they've still got money in their scheme. That's why I'll follow, hey, the prophet. Woo! We have the same religion, yes, sirree. I'll go to church on Sunday. I'll kiss the bishop's mule if there's a prophet in it for me. Ah!
Allyson!
Oh, Jacob, I'm sorry I'm late. Come on. Put your arm around my waist and take my hand. Certainly that's not so unpleasant.
It's not my arms and my hands that give me any trouble. It's the things at the bottom of my legs.
You can't fool me, Jacob Stevens. There's rhythm in your bones. I've watched you sawing wood and milking cows.
Not with my feet.
Oh, I bet you've already forgotten about San Francisco, haven't you? My name's Mary Beth. Mary Beth Warnick.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, I'll show you around town tomorrow if you like. After chores, even we women have chores, of course. Those always come first out here. Oh, there are some right pretty places up in the canyon. I can even show you those if you ride a horse. We have two horses, but we could just ride double on one if you'd rather. That'd be quite all right as well.
Oh, that's awfully kind of you, Mary Lou.
Oh, Mary Beth.
Mary Beth, but to tell you the truth, I'm only staying till the train passes back through, so... besides, your father wouldn't think too kindly of a stranger escorting his little girl around town.
He wouldn't mind.
May I ask you, though?
Yes?
Who is that young lady over there dancing with the Jacob Stevens?
Oh, that's my sister Allyson. Well, she and Jacob are practically betrothed.
Practically?
Well, yes, everyone says they can tell we're sisters because we're so much alike.
And I bet that your feet aren't so rough and calloused. But I love your hands. They're strong, honest hands. They do twice the work of any man and half of it before sunup.
Who says that?
Well, Papa does. Everyone else in town, too.
Ow! Ow!
I'm sorry.
Ow.
I...
Oh, it's fine. We'll just have to practice in my front room.
Or in the corral after we clean out the stalls.
Oh, Jacob Stevens, you can make a woman swoon with the romantic things you say. Jacob, who's that gentleman over there?
Where?
The one next to Mary Beth.
Ah, that's Daniel Adams. I met him a bit ago. You haven't seen him until now?
I guess not.
Jacob, we need your help up at the reservoir. Several of you, in fact. The dam's breaking down on the east bank where we rolled them boulders in last week. Three or four men could shore it up, I think. Are you able to go?
Well, I...
But we have to hurry. There ain't much water behind it in the first place, but what is there is washing out around it. It'll be empty by morning.
It's all right, Jacob. Go ahead. I'll walk home with Papa and Mary Beth.
All right. Tomorrow.
Go on.
May I finish this dance? It would be a shame to let such beautiful music go to waste. You're Allyson Warnick.
How did you know that?
Well, when I don't know something, I ask. It's a habit of mine.
And you are?
Didn't Jacob tell you?
When?
Well, when I was talking to Mary Beth, I saw him glance my way and answer you.
Oh, is that so?
Truthful?
I guess it is so.
Is it now?
He said he'd met you already. Mm-hmm. You're Daniel Adams.
Correct.
You've just arrived from San Francisco with your parents. And I guess that's all I really know about you. Oh, and that you are a very good dancer.
Oh, I was just about to give you the same compliment, like a feather.
Thank you.
And I have never danced with such a lovely feather.
Truthful?
Entirely. Since I saw you, I haven't been able to keep my eyes off you.
I noticed. Is it suddenly quite warm in here?
Well, perhaps a moment on the veranda. The porch?
Oh, yes, thank you.
So, were you born here?
About a year after my parents arrived in the valley. Actually, I think they may have come with yours. I've heard Papa talk about your parents.
I was 3 years old then.
Really?
Well, my mother lost my baby sister on the trail, never had any more.
Sorry.
Anyway, we left here before I was old enough to remember any of it. Good thing, too, because I'd never have come back. Well, have you ever left this place?
Oh, I've dreamed about it at times. Lots of times, really.
That's only natural.
Do you think so? Everyone around here thinks I'm, well, silly to be thinking of places far away and wishing I could see them.
I could take you.
Where?
Wherever you wanted to go, like a princess. To go wherever her heart wanted.
I have so many things I want so much to do. Don't you?
I used to think so, but my thoughts have changed in the last few minutes. I had dreams that could fill up a whole lifetime through, until we were dancing, and then I knew there are only a few things that I'd like to do. And one of them is falling in love with you. There are so many islands with winds blowing free, and ports of call waiting, and lands to see. But for now, when I'm here, you're standing by me. There's nowhere in this world I'd rather be. Just the magic of standing so close to you here persuades my heart quickly I like you near. But as boldly as feelings come to me, I fear I'll close my eyes and you will disappear.
I have dreamed of adventure my whole lifetime through, of faraway places I never knew, and I've wondered away.
and back again.
In Vienna, two schoolgirls sing out in refrain.
We'll sail down the Danube in summer's rain.
Just the magic of standing so close to persuades my heart quickly. I like you near, but as boldly as feelings to me, I fear. I'll close my eyes and you will disappear.
There are treasures on seashores for lovers to find, and castles for courting along the Rhine. But I'll always return to this moment in time. Oh. And this porch.
And this porch.
And this night.
Allyson?
Oh, Papa, this is Daniel Adams, the son of...
Yes, yes. I accompanied his family here tonight. I know your father well, Daniel. He's an honorable man.
It was a pleasure to meet your daughter, Mr. Warnick. Allyson, I hope I may call on you.
Good night, Daniel.
Good night, Allyson. Mr. Warnick, Mary Beth.
Good night, Danny.
Huh. Well, sure is a beautiful night out here, isn't it, girls? Stars shining brightly. The moon in the mountains reflecting off that lake down there. The pigs eating pine cones flying overhead, and the fire started by that bolt of lightning burning up half the town. Yeah, sure is a lovely sight, wouldn't you say, girls? Mm-hmm. Allyson?
What? Oh, yes, Papa, it is a beautiful night. I think I'll sit out here on the porch and enjoy it a while longer, if that's all right with you.
Of course.
Allyson.
Mary Beth.
Good night, Allyson.
Could it be that this is love? Could it be that wondrous that makes birds want to sing at the first hint of spring as they flitter and flutter to their nest? Is this what I've waited for? Is it why my heart is pounding like the hail on the roof or the stampeding hoof as it tries to run out of my chest? I want more of this feeling. I want more of this feeling. I want more of this feeling that I feel. But there's one thing still I need to know. Is it real? Is it real? When he holds me in his arms, there are words without expression. There's a tingling inside.
hide, and I have to confide. There are thoughts running wild up in my head. There's music when he speaks. There is magic when we're dancing. As he twirls me around with my feet off the ground, when they should be a-running instead. But I love how I'm feeling. What a wonderful feeling. I want more of this feeling that I feel. A young girl anymore. I need to get on with my life. But what's wrong with being a princess instead of just somebody's wife? There were goosebumps when we met. There was starlight. There was laughter. All the things that I dreamed would be there surely seemed to be there, and it seems what I'm after. I want more of this feeling, yes, this marvelous feeling. I want more of this feeling that I feel. But there's one thing that I want to see. Is it real, this feeling that I feel? Is it real? Is it real? Is it love?
All I'm saying, guys, this is a small town and we just got here. There's no point in stirring up trouble.
What kind of trouble am I causing?
All it takes is you walking Abraham Warnick's daughter out on the porch and a buzz starts. You beware. It did not go unnoticed, I'll tell you.
Not by the little vermin in town, that's for sure.
And I've already been told she's as much as betrothed to Jacob Stevens.
Look, if falling in love stirs up a little trouble, well, I'll just say there's a mighty big mixing spoon inside my heart.
Nonsense. It's a game you're used to playing with young girls' hearts. You've been here one day. You've known her half an hour. That does not add up to love.
She's old enough to do the arithmetic.
And so are you. A little thing like this could cause a whole lot of division around here and take away any good sentiment about us coming back.
Look, whatever you want to call what I'm feeling for Allyson, I like it. And you never know what it'll add up to.
For how long? Like that cute little Mexican barmaid you were so smitten with back in San Francisco, I suppose. That was love, too, remember?
That was nothing like this.
Well, you had her fooled. Right up till the day we left.
Oh, you want to talk about being fooled? You never told me Deseret was like this. All I ever heard you talk about were the mountains and the valley and the lake. Well, who would have thought that the valley was full of sagebrush and the lake full of salt? I helped you move here, all right? But I am getting right back out of this inevitable ghost town as soon as I can. Look, the last 100 miles on that train were through the most desolate land on Earth, except for the 100 before that.
God always seems to refine his people in the desert, doesn't he?
I'm going back. It's my decision, isn't it?
Lovely reception they gave us this evening, wasn't it?
Great grub for sure.
Oh.
Well, hello, Mr. Niner.
Ma'am?
Surprise, meeting you out here.
way out here on the edge of town? What are you doing here?
I was just going for a walk.
It's kind of a strange place to go for a walk.
Oh, you look all worn out. Do you need me to rub your neck?
I don't reckon that's a good idea.
You know, there's a saying about when your neck itches. It means you're about to fall in love.
I never heard that one.
So, what do you think of our little settlement by now?
Well, just that.
Just what?
It's mighty little.
Well, it is just a place.
My thinking
where
exactly.
Where it can be terribly lonely if you're alone, that is to say. Wouldn't you say?
Say what?
Oh, you don't have to say anything. I can tell you're the strong, handsome, quiet type.
What's your name anyhow?
Oh, I need... No, it's Hilda. Hilda Mercy. Oh, and folks told me yours. Well, you're... First name, anyway.
Well, Miss Mercy.
Hilda. It's more poetic.
Well, Miss Hilda, I think you got me figured all
wrong. I just have to come right out and ask.
Ask what?
Oh, you are so coy. I'll bet that's a word you don't even know. But we use words like that all the time in our schooling, which is just as good as back east.
I'll take your word.
My hand.
Your word. Oh.
So... What is it about me that always keeps you looking my way so?
Looking your way.
Oh, and all that talk at the social tonight about how we'd be perfect together.
I just got here this morning.
Well, there's no use wasting time in these parts. What? It is first grabs, first gets out here on the wild frontier. And I say you might as well dispense with the small talk and start a grabbing.
Oh, man. Now, I don't think that would be such a good idea.
Oh, I can feel the magnetism, can't you?
You know what I feel?
Oh,
is...
and just look at the moon out tonight. What? Can you imagine a more romantic setting?
What in the world?
Oh, and you need a woman to wash these clothes of yours. I mean, this shirt's so stiff, I bet it would stand up all by itself without you in it. Here, should we see it?
Hey, stop. Stop it now.
When I'm sitting here.
Nobody asked you to sit here.
And you scoot so near.
I ain't scooting, you're scooting.
And it's crystal clear. Exactly your intention. I start thinking thoughts.
I'm sure that's a rarity.
That I hadn't ought
to. You had not to even be here.
To even mention.
Then don't.
I suspect you see.
Well, all the time, actually.
You're a lucky guy.
Find that treasure.
To have caught my eye. Without a hardly trying. Well, I guess you're right.
And that means you're wrong.
And I guess we might.
Hey, now.
Get the griddle to fry.
Oh, no, please.
Oh, what's a single gal to do? Out on the great frontier. Looking for a man everywhere she can. Lonely every minute of the year. But even in a crowd.
Like right now?
I could always tell by that certain smell if you were somewhere near me, there's a chemistry.
There ain't nothing on the burner I can see.
And it's sad to see.
You still sitting here.
Your arm's so empty.
When my eyes are tired.
Oh, you poor dear.
And it's dark at night.
Rest here if you'd like.
And there ain't no light.
No one can even see
your
us.
Your face might conjure pretty.
Oh,
and the things you say.
Oh, and the moon's so bright.
At the end of day.
So bright they had to outlaw moonshine
sort
here.
Sort of half-witty.
Oh, what are single folk to do out on the great frontier?
Fishing for a spouse,
digging behind the house,
wishing for the kiss until I appear. So when a guy like you,
who you don't even know,
meets a gal like me,
who I don't really want to know,
and it's plain to see,
that
there's a big attraction. There's no need to wait.
Oh, goodness, Miss Hilda, yes, there is.
Or to hesitate.
Hey, what?
To get in the action.
Well, hey, Tully! It's time you saw that lumber yard of ours. Come on over when you finish hanging your sign.
I will.
Oh, Brother Stevens, come too when you finish your errands here in town. See what Tully thinks of it.
I'll head that way after lunch. Yeah.
Hey, bring your wives too.
Daniel, wait. Good morning, Jacob.
I was just on my way to your place to
serenade me with a guitar cleverly disguised as a shovel?
To return this to your pa. It's sharpened better than new now.
Well, Papa's inside the mercantile, but you could bring it by again this evening when I'm sitting out on the veranda all alone, just a staring at the stars a twinkling.
Can't get much rest staying up that late in the summer. Early to bed, early to rise, you know.
Well, I know, but the moon doesn't. He keeps looking for a young couple to shine on. Jacob, what's the matter? Jacob, I haven't seen you in 2 days since the social.
I hear out on the veranda, the moon found a couple to shine on, all right.
Jacob, that wasn't my fault. I didn't mean for Daniel to... I guess that would bother me, too.
Anyway, I gotta stop by the tanner shop on my way to the field.
Will you be coming by later?
I reckon I'll be out in the cornfield till dusk. Here. Oh, Mary Beth. I'll help you carry this bench into the mercantile for you.
Oh, no, I don't need your help.
I can carry
help.
It fine on my own.
No, but really, I want to help. Hello, Daniel. Oh, thank you, Daniel.
Thank you, Daniel.
Good morning, Daniel.
Good morning to you, Miss Warnick.
I like my first name just fine, Mr. Adams. We seem to have established a pattern.
How's that?
Oh, Jacob steps away and you take his place.
Oh, if you'd prefer, I...
Isn't it the most gorgeous morning? God gave us the most beautiful sunrises and sunsets over these big old mountains.
Allyson, have you seen what's on the other side of these mountains?
Hmm?
Really? Have you been anywhere besides this valley? I know, I asked you the other night, but... You never really answered, so...
Daniel, are there any churches in San Francisco?
Probably.
Do you believe in God?
Oh. I believe in heaven.
Yes?
The other night, when we were dancing, that's where I thought I was.
But you do believe in God, don't you?
I used to pray when I was a little boy.
Yes?
After a while, I realized I was the only one doing any talking. Like, hollering into a cave to see if anyone's there. And when your eyes adjust, you realize no one is. At least, no one that wants much to do with you.
But he does. God knows each of us. He loves us, Daniel.
I've never heard him mention my name.
Papa took Mary Beth and me to the top of that mountain over there 1 year.
You've never been anywhere, have you?
Well, have you?
Oh, I'm fixing to real soon, like I told you the other night.
Daniel, I don't know what got into me Saturday night. I mean, my stomach felt all strange and my hands were tingling and... I'm nearly engaged to Jacob Stevens, I think. We grew up together.
Yes, I got to shake hands with him at the social.
I heard. A draw. I'm impressed.
Well, I...
Jacob?
Allyson. Allyson, all I remember clearly was looking into your eyes. And when I did, they were like... Two mirrors sparkling with the same dreams I've had. I'm going back to San Francisco. Come with me. Allyson, if you don't see it now, you never will.
I've only known you 2 days, Daniel.
Yeah.
But... We're not even... I can't leave Papa Daniel. He needs me more than ever at the mill. And besides, this is my home. I love it here, surrounded by these big mountains.
Oh, they surround you, all right. Keeping you blinded from the rest of the world that's changing out there. This isn't the only place for you. It's just the only place most of you have ever known. And a place no one else wanted. Slaving away, working your little fingers to the bone, trying to make a living out of this salt-forsaken land. Well, just look at your hands. All because, what, 22 years ago, one man, a prophet, said this is where everyone should stop. Oh, I can understand what it would be like here barely making it through winter. What it's like trying to make something out of nothing. Well, look around, Pa. There's nothing here. There is so much more to life than trying to squeeze an existence out of a land, trying to starve you off of it. Mm-hmm. These mountains aren't keeping anyone else out now, and they don't have to keep you in. No, Pa. I've seen what it's like in California, where there are street lamps and markets and theaters. And Pa, you've told me about that rich farmland you and Ma left back in Ohio, where there are trees and rivers with fish jumping. And I know what it's like to wear clothes made out of cotton that don't scratch. Well, now everyone here can see what it's like to find a place somewhere better than this valley of sagebrush. When they drove that last spike out there at that promontory place, linking the two railroads, it was like two bailiffs walking into jail and, well, setting everybody free. The Union Pacific and the Central Pacific. The Union Pacific and the Central Pacific. The Union Pacific and the Central Pacific. Hey, they just drove that spike down in Promontory, said they made it out of gold. Oh, there's things out there you can only imagine. Better see 'em before you get too old. Those rails of steel are gonna carry me somewhere, maybe to an ocean shore. Gonna see them sights on the Mississippi I only got to dream about before. Well, they've got sailing ships that dock in San Francisco and fancy shops in Ohio. They stack stories seven high in New York City, and there's a bigger lake than yours north of Chicago.
Chicago! Well, this whole big country is a coming together right here in Deseret. The train is a coming and we're gonna see it running from the east out to the west. The train is a coming, 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 the train is a coming.
Yes, this whole big country is a coming together. Right here in Deseret. And I'm gonna catch that train when it starts to rumbling and see something besides this barren desert yet.
They got panes of glass in Pittsburgh that ain't wavy, and relics in Memphis from the war. I heard they're gonna build Atlanta over and make it twice as pretty as before.
Yes, this whole big country is a coming together right here in Deseret. And you better catch that train when it starts to rumbling and see something besides this barren desert yet.
I'll say for you, Mr. Niner,
Sure attracts the children here in town.
Well, they spell trouble, if you ask me. Capital T-R-U-B-L.
Hey, yeah. Careful now. Some of that loot is woose. That's dangerous. Go play somewhere else. Yeah, there's something about you the kids around here really take to.
What?
Haven't you noticed? Everywhere you go, they want to tag along. Well, they like you, Niner. If they didn't, they wouldn't be playing pranks on you all the time.
Well, maybe they do.
Yeah. Here, carry this wood to that pile over there, if you would.
Now, I... All right. Here. Go.
Well, hey, careful now.
Oh, come on now. It's just a wood pile, right?
Well, this is just another day, but how we stack this wood may make a difference in how we look back at it.
What's got you so frisky this morning, huh? You been sitting on an ice block you got stashed somewhere?
Look around you, Mr. Niner.
Now, there ain't no mister in front of my name.
Good enough. Just Niner, eh?
That's right. No last names, no titles, no nothing.
Where'd you go get a name like that?
You know, I reckon my folks gave it to me, huh? What'd you think?
Well, I think they would have fixed their last name to it. And I think you best stay off that stack of timbers you're climbing onto.
Ah.
Took two horses to pull those up, and they can start to roll.
You know, I never knew my folks, and I never heard no other name with it by the people that done fed me, but I reckon if there ever was another name, it would have been a farty in front of it. That's with an O, in case you don't hear so good.
Well, we're happy to have you here.
Now, what's happy about having me here? In fact, was anybody happy about being here at all?
Yeah, you stick around these parts long enough, Mr. Niner.
Which I don't plan to.
Yeah, you likely find out for yourself.
Now, why don't you just tell me, huh? I'll bet you know where that treasure's hid.
Well, I do.
Boy, I'll bet that's what makes you so good-natured all the time.
Now,
huh?
I suppose you're right.
But you ain't gonna tell me where it is now, are you?
Where what is?
Confound it, now you're just playing. I'll bet you know where it is too, Stevens, and you. I'll bet all of you know where it is.
What are you talking about?
The gold or the silver, I don't know. Whatever you folks found here that keeps you here, where the profit is.
Now you're talking crazy.
Like I started to say, Mr. Niner, you stick around these parts long enough, you're likely to stumble on it yourself.
There is no way in you know where that I'm sticking around here. This is a hard life, much too hard for my liking.
Now, it's the harsh climate that makes for the strong timber. You've got what it takes, I think, but it isn't easy. Whoever said it was going to be easy, whoever said it was going to be fair, whoever thought we were coming to the garden Adam left and going to live here without a care.
Well, I sure did.
Nobody said we'd be comfy and cozy. Nobody said it was going to be fun. Nobody said there'd be days besides the Sabbath we could rest or that the work would ever get done. When days discourage you, keep up the courage to do what you can before the sun goes down. Each day a little bit, pretty soon all of it, that's how the work gets done. When were we told that our days would be breezy? Who thought that it would be comfort and bliss? Why did we think God would give us all these trials to make us strong and make our burdens lighter than this? Why did we think we'd take baths in warm water? Whoever said after chores we smell lies? Where does it say in the scriptures that the land of milk and honey we'd inherit without a price?
When just a little girl I dream like other girls, a prince would come and carry me away. Servants would wait on me, my prince adoring me. Look where I am today.
When I was a young maid, so fair and naive, I dreamt of the gardens I'd grow, filled with roses and lilacs and marigolds bright, and not only corn in a row. I thought about hairpins and lovely perfume and dresses with borders of silk.
That ain't silk.
I'd have stables of horses to ride with delight, and not only
cows to be milked.
Whoever said there'd be food on the table? Whoever promised a shirt on our backs? Whoever said when diphtheria or Indians came round when we'd be spared here from their attacks?
Why did we leave our belongings behind us? Wasn't it just for the chance to be free? Why did we think when we left behind our china and our brass we'd never have more than what you see? When days discourage you, keep up the courage to do what you can before the sun goes down. Each day a little bit, pretty soon all of it, that's how the work gets done. That's how the work gets done.
It's the last day of June, Jacob. There's hardly enough time now and without a crop this year.
You plant the seed, and sometimes you look at these rows of dry dirt and you don't think anything will ever grow out of them. But you get water to them, and you wait. And then the miracle happens.
Wouldn't it just be simpler if God sent rain now? Isn't that what we've been praying for day after day, week after week, Jacob? The others have about given up. You've been up here every day except for the Sabbath, hauling water practically by yourself. I haven't seen you all of that time.
Who have you been seeing?
Jacob, don't.
I thought we were engaged.
We are. We were. Jacob, you're the closest friend I have. You're more than that. You know you are. We've talked, just like everybody else has talked about us getting married after the harvest. But Jacob, could you ever just pack up and leave this territory and go?
To San Francisco.
No. Yes. Yes, Jacob, any direction. To see the world, to see all there is out there waiting to be discovered. Could you, Jacob?
I don't suppose I'd get very far. I can't envision anything more beautiful than water flowing through rows of corn, or a pink sunset over them mountains, or Lizzie licking off her newborn calf. Lots of folks in cities have never seen those things. I just don't have the hankering.
I do. I do, Jacob. I need to see for myself. I mean, how can I know if... Oh, Jacob, I don't want to hurt you, and I'll probably just come right
probably?
Back.
Probably?
Well.
Are you willing to give up some place you love for some place you don't even know? Or someone you don't even know? He doesn't know you like I do. I know that you like to skip when you run. That you like strawberries and not blackberries. That sometimes you walk in your sleep. Or... the pranks you play with the kids in town. And he doesn't love you like I do.
Jacob, it's not him. I want
you. We've been talking for 2 years now. I need a wife, Allyson. I want to get married. Maybe I'm not the guy for you. But if you go... I'm sure I can find some enthusiastic 17-year-old who realizes what I'm worth.
Well, maybe you don't know me as well as you think you do, then.
Go ahead, then. Get on that train when it comes through here next week. It's not going to take you where you think it's gonna. And I'm not talking about San Francisco. Is this how we say goodbye?
Jacob, stop it. It doesn't have
to be
this way.
Is this where our story ends now?
Jacob, please don't make
what
me choose.
What a fool
Jacob.
I have been to believe deep within you could love such a simple man as me. I want none of this feeling, this unbearable feeling. I want none of this feeling that I feel.
Sorry.
But there's one thing that I wonder still. makes it real what I feel is this love.
Just isn't right, Allyson. Allyson, you know it isn't right. Listen to that little voice inside that you always tell me about.
I don't hear it.
Oh, and it isn't fair.
Oh, just think of it, Mary Beth. I can fit all of my regular clothes in this satchel and my Sunday dress in this one. Isn't it exciting?
Why should I be excited? I'm not going anywhere. And I don't even think you're going to a church there. I haven't seen Daniel come to church once.
Well, I'll be a good influence on him.
Well, here, maybe, but not there. Listen to me, Allyson, please.
Can you just imagine standing on a veranda or on the ocean shore, watching the ships come in and out of the bay?
Well, who says you wouldn't be standing on a dusty street, watching Daniel go in and out of a tavern? I've heard rumors about a lady friend he left behind at a saloon there. A pretty little senorita named Isabella.
I think you're just jealous.
Well, so what if I am? You had your pick. And you had the best man in the territory. And now you want to leave him? And us and all we've worked for here to run off to San Francisco with someone you hardly know?
Mary Beth, it wouldn't be running off. It's only for a short time. Daniel would be more escorting me.
He'd be paying for your ticket. Don't think he isn't expecting some loose change in return. It doesn't look right, and Papa doesn't approve of it.
You come with us in a week.
What?
You know what they say about two women having eyes for the same man? Keep them together and nothing improper ever happens. Papa would let us go then, and Brother Higgins can help at the mill until the harvest. If there is a harvest.
Well, it's not like we have any money, Allyson.
I bet Daniel would pay for your ticket, too.
Well, if you weren't so willing to hop on that train, Daniel might not be going at all. And if you just marry Jacob, like you ought to, if you had any brains, well then maybe Daniel would go looking for another girl around
and that
here.
Just might be you.
Well, I saw him first.
Mary Beth, I don't want you to be angry with me.
Allyson. Jacob loves you so much. And if you marry Daniel, Jacob would never be interested in me.
Whoa. Who said anything about marriage, Mary Beth? I want to see places. Just imagine the cobblestone streets, the tall buildings, the fancy shops, even rainy days for a whole week straight.
You're not fooling anyone, Allyson. Well, you're caught up with him. I just hope you know what you're doing.
I don't. That's the adventure of it, Celia. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm bobbing in the stream. But oh, the romance. And this is my chance to see things that I've never seen. I don't know where I'm going. I almost want to shout. But somehow I feel this trip will reveal what my life is really about. Goodbye, Deseret, goodbye. If I had wings, I would fly up over the mountains and off towards the sun and never come down till I die. It's all just so exciting. I'm off to see the world. But deep down inside, I have to confide. I'm trembling like some little girl. I'm not afraid of leaving. I've dreamed about this day. So why do my knees keep shaking like trees when I think of going away? Goodbye, Deseret, goodbye. I want to leap to the sky. My young heart is pounding so hard it may burst, and I couldn't sit down if I tried. I wonder if it's foolish to run away like this. But how will I know if I never go to see things that I would have missed? I'm tingling with excitement. I don't know what I'll find. train and ne'er be the same as a young girl that I've left behind. Goodbye, Deseret, goodbye. I know someday I may cry. I'll think of you often and come back someday. But for now, Deseret, goodbye.
Living, ain't it grand? There's so much to see. Walking down these crowded streets, feeling nothing but free. City sidewalks, how about that? Vendors selling ware. Nod to ladies, tip your hat. If you don't, who cares? Did you ever think you'd see a place like this back in Deseret? Think of all the sights you would have had to miss and someday regret. Ain't it splashing? Ain't it great? What more can you say? Can't you hear excitement coming? Headed straight my way. Hello, ladies, would you care to show us around? These young girls are from the country, never been to town. Anything you've ever wanted, you can find somewhere in this place. But if you don't want to be found by someone, hey, you're just a face. Where you going? What's the score? Stick with us a while.
take you fancy places, gonna make you smile. Here we are on Market Street. This was our old star. The best part of working here was the place next door. Oh, the things that we have seen, what a life we'll lead. I guess we have everything. What more could you need?
Look at these fellows looking my way. What do they think they see? Turning their heads as I'm walking by. I feel their eyes on me. Pull out the mirror, see how I've grown. Feeling such feelings I've never known. Fancy and free out here on my own. I guess I'm a woman now. You thought that I was young and naive and like Eve, give me that fruit to eat. I get to say what's poured in my glass, filled to the brim with sugar and sass. Toss me the manual, teach the class, 'cause I'm a woman now. I want to try everything once, things they don't teach you in school. Don't try to stop me, don't get in my way.
Allyson?
We need to get to the train. We have to go home. Please.
Allyson, what are you
Please
doing out
go
here?
Home.
Allyson, wake up. Are you all right?
Oh, Papa.
Is it that same dream again?
The one with Daniel and all of the Sister Stevens and Brother White. Oh, I try to rescue Daniel from that awful senorita. But then Mary Beth.
Oh, Mary Beth. Mary Beth, you do not have to grow up so fast. You don't have to teach classes or eat fruit or pour anything at all into your glass.
Oh, what? I guess I'm not making much sense, am I? I'm just so worried about you.
You are worried about me?
I just don't know what it all means. I'm sorry to have woken you again, Papa.
I came out because I thought I heard some of the kids from town playing out by the stacked timber. They love mischief on a summer night, but they could get hurt. Besides, my shoulders have been aching a bit from carrying so much water today.
Oh, poor Papa. If only Mary Beth or I had been a son, it would have been...
Terrible. The way a body ages. Lucky for me, I've got two beautiful daughters to help keep things up around here. Don't know what I would have done without you two.
Well, we need rain soon, otherwise there won't be anything to keep up come winter. What will we do, Papa?
Yeah, we'll see it through, just like we always have. We may not know how,
well, it's
but...
never been this bad before, has it?
It was bad when the crickets came, and the Lord sent the gulls. It's just as easy to send clouds.
But why does it have to be so hard?
Yeah, it's the harsh climate that makes for the
makes
strong...
makes the strong timber.
But even strong timber burns in a hot fire. Good night, Papa. Hey, Mary Beth. I love you. More than tongue can tell.
Are you really going to let us go on Wednesday, Papa? Well, you've got to talk to her. You know she's making a big mistake.
Well, you see how wise you're becoming? I've spoken with her almost every night. It's like the proverb says, raise up a child in the way she should go, and when she's about grown up, she won't wander too far off. Allyson has been raised well. Now I got to loosen up the rope a little.
Well, yes, and she'll hang herself with it all right.
Mary Beth, when I was a boy, I loved to hike up in the mountains. Not like we have here, but that's what they seemed at the time. There was a cliff that I always wanted to look over. I dreamed about it, really, but I didn't dare go near. Then one day an idea occurred to me. Got a strong rope, I tied it around the end of a nearby tree, and measured out just enough slack to tie the other end around my waist. Walk right out to the edge of that cliff, and look over.
And?
Wasn't as much to see as I thought there'd be. So I packed up my rope and I went home.
I don't understand.
Allison's got a good rope. She's still measuring it some, I reckon, but I think she's still got it cinched pretty tight around her waist. I wouldn't want her to cast it off.
Tonight. place that God would call our home? Was it just a place that no other people wanted?
Why did Zion need to stand alone?
It's only nine and the sun's beating hot. If we don't get rain, what do we got? Don't got nothing, you can't descend. Everything dies in this parched up land. We toiled and slaved in the burning heat, but we'll solve this winter with no grain to eat.
More than a place to plant our children in their grave.
What kind of man did it take to cross the mountains?
What does it take to be called a pioneer?
We must pray for rain and believe that our Father in heaven will hear. It's a trial of our faith and a test of our strength, but we know that the Lord wants us here.
All he asks of us is our part. There are times that try every man. We must all do our best and let God do the rest. And when others would faint, we must stand. Let us kneel and pray to our God, and together ask him to show once again in his love, his great power from above, that our crops and our faith both may grow.
Let us
you kids, everybody, hey, those are not toys. You just give me that back, young lady. I'll give it here. Give me that shovel. Give me that shovel, boy. Stop running away. Hey, get off of there. Go on home now. Go. Hello, ladies.
Hello, Mr. Niner.
You know, that looks awfully heavy for you ladies to be wrestling with all on your own. Perhaps you should wait for your men folks. Excuse me, I meant man folk.
Well, you certainly have a way with words, Mr. Niner.
You know, I've been wondering about with you and Mr. Stevens, well, all three of you, that is, and Mr. Stevens, in the evening, how do you decide where he's gonna,
I mean, how do you decide which of you is gonna, you know? Lovely day here in town.
It's hot as a furnace, the corn's withering on the stalk, and every man in the valley is off carrying water to what meager crops we have.
Oh, man.
Don't you plan on eating this winter, Mr. Niner?
You know, Mademoiselle, when that first feathery little snowflake falls upon the lush green fronds of desert territory, I hope, like Hades, I'm back in civilization.
Well, we'd miss you.
Terribly.
And I might just go with him.
Don't you like it here, Mr. Niner?
Well, let's just say
he does. He just doesn't know he does, but he does, don't you? Just you listen. Pretty soon you might hear him say it.
Say what?
I do.
I won't.
Bet you will.
I will not. Let's just say I see no profitable reason to stay in deserted territory.
Bet you will.
Well, if you do stay here through the winter, Niner, you'll be mighty glad somebody was tending to the field while you were sitting on your skinny little...
And things are different here in Deseret, Mr. Niner. Don't you know why Brother Brigham named us that?
You know, it ain't so hard to figure out, lady. It just means little desert, like a pipe and pipette. Desert and Deseret, see? Menu and minuet. And I never even went to school.
Well, you could have fooled us, Professor.
Oh, isn't he funny?
No, it is the name given to the honeybee.
And come winter, when the worker bees come swarming back into the hive, they kick the lazy drones out of the way.
And how do they do that?
In the springtime in the garden, when the flowers and their colors come alive. Already getting anxious to get going in the hive. In the book that Joseph gave us, it was called the Deseret. We got to work like honeybees for everything we get. Deseret.
In the orchards, in the valley, just waiting for the light of dawn to come.
All the honeybees are buzzing with their cousins and their busy little hum.
They're stirring with excitement, knowing days are short with so much to get done.
They fly back and forth from blossoms in the meadow to their home. They work from dawn to dusk, except that privileged little drone, Deseret. Swarming back into that crowded hive, then they push that lazy wolf and drone out of the way, cause he's a worthless little cuss after his one important day. In the winter when the snow is on the ground, if we don't want to starve and freeze. In the summer we had better get to work just like those little honey bees. Got to till the soil and plant the crops and harvest autumn fruit from all the trees. If you listen very closely, it's the buzzing you can hear from that little bitty insect that can sting you in the rear. Deseret.
Any mind, Mr. Niner?
Hey, I ain't paying them nothing. They can put it on my bill.
Oh, children!
Get out of
children,
here!
Children, run along now!
Bother
children,
someone else
Mr.
for once
Niner
in your
like
life. I don't care. Parents, go. Just go on home. Go.
Get out of here. Sometimes you just have to know how to deal with children. You can see I have that sort of neck. How many do you want?
Firm.
Five? Well, that's what I've always thought.
Now, Miss Hilda, wait.
Well, not that there's anything wrong with eight. Eight's a perfectly good number. I think I'm getting a little old.
Miss Hilda, I don't want no kids.
Oh, nonsense.
I have my heart set on it.
How'd we start talking about kids anyhow?
Oh, you rascal. I can tell what's on your mind,
Miss Hilda, Miss Hilda, there ain't nothing on my mind.
Well, it is just a good thing I came along in the nick of time, I'd say. Well, wouldn't you say?
For what?
Well, to save you from those Stevens women.
Now, I believe I could have protected myself just fine.
Oh, Mr. Niner, what a team we make. The perfect couple.
Miss Hilda, we ain't a couple.
Yet.
I'm getting on that train when it comes through here next week, on its way to San Francisco, right behind Daniel Adams and them Warnick girls, if their daddy really is foolish enough to let him go.
Of course I will.
Will what?
Well, go with you. You were getting ready to propose, weren't you? Oh, I guess I just skipped ahead a little bit. You know, I shouldn't do that. It ruins all the suspense, whether I'm going to say yes, whether I'm going to say no. Here, let's start over.
I don't think that would be such a good idea.
What? Getting down on one knee and asking the love of your life to become your betrothed?
No.
You know, my daddy always said that the lucky man to have me would have to ask him for my hand first.
Oh, yeah?
But he's dead now, so you can't. But it still makes a woman feel special if you get down on one knee when you're proposing to her.
That's just it, Miss Hilda. I ain't proposing. I'm getting on that train, and you're not, and I ain't never coming back.
But what about us? I mean, I did just practically save your life.
No!
Oh. Oh, I see. Well, goodbye, Mr. Niner. I guess I was just fooling myself.
Miss Hilda,
again.
Wait.
I will thank you to please not call upon me outside your outhouse again until your departure. And I hope you have a wonderful trip back to San Francisco, where you will never find your treasure because it was sitting under your nose the whole time you were here.
What?
That's right, Mr. Niner. It was yours for the taking, but you didn't deserve it. And you don't deserve me.
Excuse me, Miss Warnick. I guess I wasn't looking where I was going.
Or maybe you were.
What?
Well, I'd say that you were looking in the exact direction that your heart's a-pulling you.
You think so, huh?
I think I can spot things like that pretty well.
Well, tell me, Miss Gypsy, when you look in your crystal ball and you see your own reflection, which way are your eyes a-gazing?
Well, now I...
I see things, too.
Now, Mr. Niner, Hilda would be lost out in a big city, but out here on the frontier, she'd make some lucky man feel like a king.
You know, if you told me where that treasure was hid, we could both be kings. Or a king and a queen.
Is that really all you're looking for?
You're darn tootin' it is. I don't... Well, I suppose. What are you looking for? You grinning at? Look at you with your ribbons and lace.
Look at you with your unshaven face.
Well, look at us standing here talking side by side.
Though we look a little bit different from the outside looking in,
we're both standing here dream about love.
Look at you, dirty shoes on your feet.
Well, look at you, huh? Prim and proper and sweet.
Look at us,
sitting out here all alone. Though we grown up kind of different, the feeling's still the same. We're both sitting here dream about love. I guess we're two of a kind. Oh yes, just two of a kind. Each hoping that we will find this thing we call love. Oh yes, we're two of a kind. I guess we're of the same mind. When it comes
comes to waiting for.
Looking for,
dreaming about love. Look at me, sleeping out on the ground.
Look at me, pillows fluffed all around.
Look at us, just as opposite as two could be. But if you look beneath the skin, you may see that we're next of kin. 'Cause just like everyone else, we're dreaming about love. I guess we're two of a kind. Oh yes, carved from the same rind. Each hoping that we will find this thing we call love. Oh yes, we're two of a kind. Like everybody we know,
just two of a kind.
Most anywhere that we go, we keep hoping for, looking for, dreaming about love.
Well, them's my feelings, Abram. It's not that I'm worried about Jacob finding him a good wife. You know that. It's just that this feels wrong as a fish sitting on a cactus, that's all. They shouldn't be going. And I'm surprised you're letting them, frankly. I'm just surprised.
Tully.
Tully.
Abram, I just want to tell you again about how bad I feel.
Listen, Tully.
I'm sorry my son is taking your daughters up to San Francisco and all, and Jacob too.
It'll be all right. Really, it will. After all, we're friends, aren't we? Aren't we that, no matter what?
Yes.
Well, yes, of course we are.
Anyway, trust me. I got a feeling here.
Papa,
we'll talk again later this afternoon, all right? I suppose. Yeah, the girls are about packed, and I best be helping them.
Come on, Tully.
Oh, Papa. I've never felt so excited, I guess.
Huh. Well, I've never seen you, so...
Oh, is that the train whistle I heard?
I didn't hear if it was.
Oh, Daniel and Niner should be here by now. That train only stops long enough to walk
up. We'll hear it. Now, let's see your return tickets again. I want to make sure you girls get
I'm
back
not
safe.
A girl.
Are you young ladies get back safe and sound from this little adventure?
Mine tucked away already. Right to where you told me to keep it.
Good. Nobody will be looking in that direction. Even in your sleep, remember?
Well, I'm not planning on sleeping. Not till we get back. There's too much to see, don't you think, Allyson?
Oh, well, there are a lot of new things.
Is Jacob coming to say goodbye?
I don't believe so.
But he left early this morning for the cornfield, about the same time I saw Brother Higgins head up to the canyon to check on the dam. I don't expect either of them to be back soon.
Oh, I'm going to run into town to see what's holding them up. I'll walk, so I don't perspire. I mean, I'm not really going to run, and it's not like they're actually being held up, right? It's not like we have robbers here, right? Right? Are you nervous, Allyson? I mean, you probably are, but I'm not. Can't you tell? I'll be back with them, all right, Papa?
Go ahead. So, still time to change your mind.
Oh, Papa. This valley has been my home for 20 years. But the first time I danced with Daniel, there was this tingling. And then when he's talked to me about Singapore and Madrid and New York City... Oh, I don't know. I start dreaming, and it just makes this farm seem so small.
Your mama used to talk the same.
Mama?
Some warm summer nights, we'd sit out here with our shoes kicked off and our feet propped up on that rail like we own the world. I know how we'd dream.
Well, I barely remember Mama. Thank you for taking care of us all these years by yourself. Papa?
Yes?
Would you still love me if...
Well, there will never be any ifs about that.
I know, but if I married Daniel instead of Jacob?
Yep. Tell you the truth, I think you'd be foolish to marry Jacob. I'm glad to hear you're thinking better of it.
Why, Papa, I thought that you...
That I like Jacob? Well, I do. But that doesn't mean he's good enough for my eldest daughter. Now, this Daniel, he comes into your life, and right off you knew he was something special, didn't you?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Do you love him?
I think so.
Yeah? See, it was that easy for you to see that you love Daniel and not Jacob.
I love Jacob, too. It's just
Well, you've known Daniel for 4 weeks. You've known Jacob your whole life. Now, so in another 4 weeks, well, you're bound to love Daniel twice as much.
I suppose.
Yeah? I think he's the man for you, all right?
He is going to be a merchant like his father. He said he would show me the world.
Well, you see there, the excitement of traveling to the South Seas. Well, sharks swimming around the boat and hoping yours isn't the one in 20 that sinks. Standing at the rail till you get over the seasickness, enjoying the cold saltwater baths at the bow. Well, the bustling marketplaces in Malaysia with the skinned pigs and chickens hanging by their feet and taking care not to get the cholera or the malaria. Yeah. Or the bullfights in Spain with the noisy streets all about and a different hotel room every week and not knowing where you'll sleep or what you'll eat. or Paris with the fine restaurants and the French women. Or New York with Daniel coming home late from business dinners with beer and tobacco smoke on his clothes. Well, now that's real adventure. What could Jacob give you to compare? He's dull.
He's just quiet.
Well, he goes to bed before a party's half over.
Well, he works hard and gets up early.
Because he has to work all day just to make a living.
For a family of 8 children.
Yeah, with his muscle rather than his head.
Farming is respectable work. We would always have food on our table.
Well, he's not half the man this Daniel is.
He's the finest man I've ever met besides you. How can you say that?
It takes so long fixing a plow.
But it doesn't need repairing again for years. He takes pride in his work.
Yeah. He's not near as handsome.
He's strong and handsome, I think.
And children. Well, look at the size family he comes from. And he's always talking about wanting a bunch himself. You'd be expecting in a month.
Well, I love children. I've always wanted a large family, too.
Yeah, he's only building a 2-room cabin on that piece of land of his with a corn patch for a yard and pigs and chickens and calves running about.
I love farm life. It's as good as any hotel room with sharks and cholera and cold baths and French women and...
Yes?
Oh, Papa.
Allyson. You know that little tree out the back of the house?
The one you moved from next to the barn?
Before that, from where the chicken coop was standing. Your mother had me bring it and another sapling in the wagon when we left Nauvoo. I think she wanted a reminder of home. She never could decide where she wanted that tree. I must have moved it half a dozen times. Never has grown very tall.
Well, what happened to the other one? This is it?
On the edge of town, by the side of the road, there's a tree growing mighty and tall. It holds out its branches like great loving arms that gently beckon to all. We planted it here in this poor rocky soil. Not once did it ever complain. It just sank down its roots, deep as it could, and soaked up the sun and the rain. And I wonder about all the things it has seen, tales it has heard, though it's never been anywhere else. By the side of the road, I've often gone out and sat down to rest and propped up my feet in that shade and looked up through the branches at some tiny nest a robin in springtime had made. Lovers who once carved their names in its bark, and children who played round the base, will soon be forgotten as time marches on and others have taken their place. And I'm glad that this tree with all of its wood has stood here and grown as big as it could. Through the wind and the gales and the storms it has stood, giving shade by the side of the road. I've leaned back my head with my eyes slightly closed and dreamed of the places I'd go. If the crops were all in and the house boarded up away from the cold winter snow. On one such day when my heart roamed away, it whispered to me while I rest, as many as pass on their way to the east seem to journey along to the west. And I think of it now, and I think of it when I start wondering how and wondering when. I'll see all the places that I've never been, in my house by the side of the road. Yes, I wander about, all my feelings to roam, when my feet get to itching to take off from home. Then I recall how this old tree has grown, giving shade by the side of the road.
Townsfolk came to give you a cheery send-off. Everybody's here.
Is Jacob here?
I said everybody, didn't I? Is your dictionary missing that page, Ms. Warnick? Now, come on. We got to get you gals on your way.
Well, hey, you're looking mighty dapper today, Mr. Niner. Looks like you finally see the inside of a bathtub.
You think so, huh?
Maybe the inside of a church is next, huh?
Mr. Niner, sir?
Yeah?
Yeah! Allyson, if you go, it'll never be the same, even if you come back. I'd always know there was something more important to you than me.
Jacob.
I want you to follow your dreams. I was just hoping your dream centered around me and what you and I could have right here.
Allyson, we should probably get going to the train depot. Got our tickets paid for. Let's get going.
Hey! It's gone again. The dam's giving way. We gotta take some timber and dig it in silent. It may be gone before we get back up there.
Now we can grab some small timber from the pile over here.
Grab this big one.
I got it. Oh, Jacob, no!
Right, we'll have to try and pry it up. Shout for the others to come back.
Hey, folks, come on back. We need your help.
He can't even breathe. Daniel, you've gotta help him. Please.
I'm not budging it. It's too heavy.
Oh, God.
Allyson.
God, please help him.
It's no use.
Please, God. Please, God. Oh, my goodness. Oh, thank you, Daniel. Thank you, God. Jacob? Jacob? Papa, did you see he's breathing? Jacob, can you hear me? Jacob, I love you with all of my heart. I do. I truly do.
My heart is hurting so inside. Or is it just a foolish pride? If not for me, he would have died. And she'd be mine. But it wasn't me who raised that log. It wasn't me who raised that log. I know I've never been that strong. I wasn't then. What happened then? What have I seen? What is God telling me? What might have been? If I had faith to sink my roots down in this soil. Now heaven knows my name and knows my thing I had the strength to do. Was it for them or for me too? Am I the kind of person who deserves such gifts? What does he have in store for me? What kind of man must I now be to have that joy of theirs I see with someone else? What happened then? Who was there too? Without his help to lift my arms, what could I do? I never thought I was the kind of man to grow. Now heaven knows my name and knows my soul. I've seen a miracle of God. I felt his hand behind the rod as it touched me.
Daniel, Papa, we need to get him off of this hard ground. We could carry him into the house.
Yeah, maybe we better just leave him here.
What? No! We need to get him off of this hard ground and out of the sun as soon as he can... You can walk! Oh, I'm sorry. You can take as long as you want to recover, because I want to hold you and be close to you for the rest of my life. Our lives. Oh, Jacob, I thought I knew what I wanted.
What in the world?
But it wasn't until you were under that log that I suddenly realized that everything I could ever want is right here in this valley. Everything that matters anyway. All the people I love, and especially the man that I want to spend the rest of my life with, if he'll still have me.
I...
Will you, Jacob Stevens?
Yes.
Oh,
how is it?
The dam is gone. Every bit of it. And every bit of water behind it. How's Jacob?
Maybe a rib or two, but he'll be all right.
Is there nothing to be done?
It'll take a miracle now. That's all we can hope for, pray for.
I'm sorry you and Niner missed the train, Daniel.
There will be others. Besides, Niner didn't bring his bags with him. Weren't you going, Niner?
Well, you know that treasure you folks got hid up here, I got a feeling in my bones I'm going to stumble over it any day now. Right. Or maybe I'm stumbling over it already. I guess you could say that I'm proposing to
That's
stay.
That's all I want to hear!
Nope.
Oh.
Hey. You gave me back that cake.
Holy smokes, look at them clouds rolling in. They're as dark as night.
Oh, lightning, did you see that?
Look at the dust rolling up across the valley in front of it. We're in for a good one.
We all will soon. Look, you can see it falling all the way to the valley floor. Here it comes.
Oh, my God.
Here it comes.
The rain is coming. The rain is coming. The rain is coming. The rain is coming. Hey, there's clouds out there that are coming our way, looking like they're full of rain. They're a-chugging and a-churning like the smoke from the stack of that old train.
I can hear the thunder rolling across the valley. Can't think of a nicer sound. Gonna clap our hands, gonna shout Hosanna when the raindrops start to hit the ground.
We'll have water for the horses in the stable.
And the grass they have to eat won't all be brown.
Put the barrels underneath the downspouts quickly,
and the chickens in the coop before they drown.
Well, this whole dry country, it ain't gonna wither, not here in Deseret. The rain is a-coming and the streams will start a-running. Hope that we will all get drenching wet.
We'll see these valleys grow. Our crops will not fail. And someday our children and their children, generations of children, will look back and say, thank God for a people who had what it took to come to these barren valleys and make them blossom as a rose. Who found something to love and reason enough to stay here amongst the mountains of the Lord in our beloved Deseret.
That's right.
I like the Deseret.
I love the shade beneath the mango tree. When work is done, it's waiting for me. I love the mountains reaching the sky. This is the country where I want to die.
This is the place for growing up strong.
This is the place where we can belong. This is the place for worship and song. This is the place to worship.